How's everybody? I know a lot of you. How cool is Jimmy? Let's start with that. And what a great opportunity he and his business partners, John and Ed, they flew all the way in from California just to be here today. And we're very, very happy to have them here. They've got an incredible repertoire of work among them, so you should all be very eager and excited to get this opportunity, because a lot of the paid internships, you don't actually get to travel and you don't get housing paid for, so that's kind of cool. Welcome. And are you all ready for the day? I know a lot of you have traveled really far, so who's here from California? Sonia. Yeah, there she is. And who's here from Virginia? I want you guys to make some noise when we call you out. Maryland? DC? Where else are you from? Atlanta? I knew that was going to happen. I had somebody say they drove here from Birmingham, Alabama. Where are you? There he is, all the way in the back. Hello. If I didn't call your city out, yell some cities out to me. Where are you from?
Detroit.
Oh, so my creative. Ah, yay. And that means Mike's here with you somewhere. I don't see him. Where is he? Oh, well, he's somewhere. Ah, hi, Mike. And any other cities? Did I miss anybody?
Austin,
we love you. GSDNM might have a job for you, Austin. So I just want to make sure that I thank all of our sponsors. We've got some really great agencies here today, and they're part of the reason that this gets to happen every year. And so please, let's hear it for our sponsors. They're all downstairs. You're going to meet with a lot of them, but they are terrific, and we really value them. They're our partners in this. And I also want to start out by thanking all of the creatives who are here to lend their time. You're going to meet a lot of great creatives from a lot of different agencies. Some of those creatives are sponsoring agencies, some of them aren't. So you'll meet everybody downstairs for portfolio reviews and recruiting, and you'll have a really good day. And I think, you know, many of you might end up with jobs when you leave here, which is the goal. In addition, I want to introduce someone who is just phenomenal. He is from Brooklyn, originally, Bed-Stuy. Who's here from Brooklyn? Yay, Brooklyn's in the house. Usually there's a lot larger Brooklyn representation. and Londell McMillan is a legend in the media sphere. He started out as an entertainment attorney. He then went on to purchase The Source. He is the owner and publisher of The Source magazine, one of the largest hip-hop magazines out there. He's really sort of changed and continues to change the face of this media industry and the representation of multiculturals and media. And he is a powerhouse and a force, and he's here today to speak with you about his career and about your career and your goals. So please give a really, really, really warm and loud welcome to Londell McMillan.
Thank you. Good morning. That was kind of whack. We can do better than that. Good morning.
Good morning.
That's what's up. That's what's up. Welcome to New York for all of those who are out of town. I heard the A is in the building heavy. Where's the A? I see a lot of folks there from Atlanta, but people from all over the United States. Welcome to New York. It's always a pleasure to see people come to this city. I'm a native New Yorker from Brooklyn. Grew up in housing projects that many of you have heard Jay-Z talk about in his records, Marcy Houses and Tompkins Houses, and went to school here in New York pretty much all of my life and career. And so it's always, I feel like a New York ambassador when people come to the city. So welcome again. And we look forward to this wonderful day. I want to thank the One Club. Let's give them a shout out and give them a big hand. Let them hear you. Kevin, Tracy, and Yoshi. And I also want to want to thank my friend Jimmy Smith and his colleagues and friends who had the boldness and the, I guess, the sense of vision to ask the question that many of us ask, but in an environment where sometimes people think that you should not ask for certain types of demands that are only right, but it's not only what you do, it's sometimes how you do it. And this was a great vision, and it's great to see it come to fruition. So let's give them all a great hand. Of course, the sponsors, we wouldn't be here without the advertising sponsors here who show by their commitment and their dedication and their deeds that the issue of multicultural inclusion and diversity is important. This is not new. This is something that we've been talking about for many, many years, and it comes up all the time, and it will be something that we will continue to advance for the rest of our lives. Let's get used to it. It's part of our rich tradition in America, and it's okay. But we want to thank those allies that are visionary and supportive of cultural inclusion and diversity, not only because it's a good thing to do, but it's also the rich thing to do. It's not only rich in culture, but it's rich in profits these days. And we'll talk a little bit about that. So let's give a loudest round of applause for all of the sponsors here today that you'll be meeting with. You know, as I thought about what I wanted to say to you, I just really wanted to just emphasize with an exclamation point that these are exciting times. Exciting times. It's exciting times in the world. It's exciting times here in our country, the United States. It's an exciting time in this industry of advertising, marketing, and media. It's truly a special time for people of color, because the world is changing at a very, very, very rapid rate. Technology is bringing so many people together at a very, very rapid rate. The notion of what they talk about with total market now, which is kind of the inclusion of all folks together, coming up with stories that matter, creative ideas, relationships and communication to people that matter, all people that matter, is something that is a very much at this time at the forefront of a discussion. It wasn't that way 10 years ago. Right now, it is very heavy. People are trying to figure out how to capture the total market enterprise. You don't do that just by spending money in all of the different media publications out there, or the various different technology devices and sites and digital platforms and television and radio. You have to come up with ideas and stories. So it's an exciting time in terms of sharing your story, feeling great about your story. But there's a lot of work to do so that you can take your creativity and your story ideas and then find a way to integrate them into the business of advertising. So we'll talk about some of those tips later on, but I want to tell you a little bit about my story, just so you know a little bit about myself. I grew up in Brooklyn in Bed-Stuy. My mother was a beautician. And she did hair, obviously, and cosmetology, and she had her own beauty salon, and we lived in Brooklyn. She was from, actually, Georgia. My father was from North Carolina. So I was the first generation New Yorker. And then I went to high school in a school called Brooklyn Technical High School. So I thought I wanted to be a technical engineer. Then after getting involved in tech, I thought, well, I really like people more than tech. At least I thought I did. And so then I I was also an athlete, so I played basketball and football, and I was able to go to Cornell University and join the School of Industrial Labor Relations, which ties into this whole job career fair, where I was very active in the world of work and getting people to work, personnel, human resources, and getting people engaged in organizations that employ people to produce products or services. And so understanding that our number one investment is not the investment in only your idea, not just the investment in your product, but the investment in what? In people, right? Understanding that people power is very, very important. So investing in human capital and people who create ideas, because we'll create the story, we create the ideas. And so then I decided I wanted to go to law school. Somehow, you know, back in those days, almost every parent was like, my baby gonna go to law school, my baby gonna go be a doctor, a lawyer, you know, the careers were very limited, right? And you know, as the first generation going to college, that's, I always heard that in my head. So I didn't know exactly what I was gonna do, but I figured, let me just keep on going. I went on to law school. So then I ran across a gentleman who's now deceased, a legendary cat. His name was Reginald Lewis. Reginald Lewis was a lawyer who turned into an entrepreneur and became the first African-American man to acquire a $1 billion company. It was called TLC Beatrice at the time. And I met him as I was the national chair of the National Law Students Association. And he said to me, he said, this was in 88. He said, young man, go into business, because business will be the civil rights of your generation. Now, I'm talking about my generation. There's another generation for you. But he said, go into business. That will be the civil rights of your generation. Now, why did he say that? Because he had asked me, what is it that you're going to law school for? And after studying the world of work and labor, you know, I really had a strong passion for doing the right thing. And I told him, I said, I want to be a civil rights lawyer. And he said, young man, go into business. And that hit me. But growing up in the arts and sports was still very much in my heart. It was just tugging at me. You know, I just loved music, I love sports, I love entertainment. I just couldn't get it away. So it was a passion for me, and I wanted to connect my passion to where I thought the opportunity existed and where I thought I could make a mark on society. So I started figuring out, how do I put those things together? And I say that because I'm going to come back to you later on and say, how do you put together where your passion lies and the opportunity exists? Then how do you research to find out what's the scope of those options so that you can connect those dots? Okay? You're already doing a great job because you're here. And some of those dots have been kind of aggregated for you with Here Are All the Black People and the One Clubs Initiative. But there's still more work to do. But again, just concluding my story, I then graduated, and then I went to one of the corporate law firms, and I started representing Time Warner and the Discovery Channel. I left there early, and at 30 years old, I decided I was going to build my own law firm. I wanted to focus on entertainment, artists, athletes, and be their legal advocate. I felt that in at that time, that athletes and entertainers, particularly growing up in the hip-hop generation, I felt that artists, they weren't getting their fair share of the piece of the pie. And I thought that they needed an advocate that could advocate on their behalf. So I said, you know, I'm going to leave the corporate firm now after I've developed my skills, learned. I said I was going to now use those skills to be an advocate for justice in my mind, but really it was an entertainment industry, it was arts industry, it was the creative industry. I had passion in it, and I wanted to use my skill set in that area, which again is what I'm encouraging you to do. So I went and I started my own firm at 30 years old, and we grew the firm to become the largest black and brown firm, the African American, Hispanic, Latino firm in the city across entertainment and corporate life. And then I started acquiring businesses along the way with some of my partners. I started investing in shows and tours and going all around the country, getting into advertising, some real estate, just being interested and curious, which is what I'm encouraging everyone to do. Stay curious, stay thirsty to learn. Wanting to be creative, networking, having just a great personality with people, looking for positive people, being kind, all of the basic things that your parents, they teach you and you know exist. Once you get this education, you can't get arrogant with it. You now have to humble yourself and really go all in and show that you've got not just skills, but you've got that personality. And you're not fearless. And you can do it. And you can make it happen, right? And so just things started coming your way. And they're going to come your way. Because, again, you're at an amazing time right now, right? And things just started coming to me. Just started coming. And I started sharing. And I started giving it back to people. And it started coming back more. And then I'm saying to you that if you just believe in yourself, and take that risk in yourself, put that investment in yourself, it's all gonna come to you. So I believe the biggest key for me was being prepared, staying inspired, and finding that passion and networking, right? Which is what I'm saying that I need you to do. That is my story. And what happened, the clients came thereafter. You know, first, there were the artists that were painters and songwriters and producers, and then came the hip-hop artists that I loved that were in my community, the sports, the athletes. Then came bigger artists, you know. Spike Lee came. Then came Prince. And once you get a big one, everybody comes, you know. Then I started getting my mom's favorite artists, like Aretha Franklin and Roberta Flack. Can I get a hand clap for Aretha Franklin and Roberta Flack? You don't know culture. You got to know that story. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. What it means to me. I can't sing, but I got passionate about it. And this is a woman. She's speaking about respect, but it speaks to me. When she says respect, she's talking about me. That's what I tell my girlfriend. R-E-S-P-E-C-T, baby. You know, but then they start to come. Things start to happen. People start to come into your life. Going back to kindness and how you treat people and being positive, they start to feel your light. You want to let your light shine. Your light can't shine if you don't believe in yourself. You're going to go have all of these interviews. I'm telling you, and I don't even know you, you all are amazing. You've got to let your light shine. You got to believe that. And if you don't believe it on a 100, take that 10% you believe it and believe that 10% 100. And just focus on that and be a great 10. You're going to have an opportunity today. You're going to have an opportunity today. And you're going to meet with people, and they're going to meet with you, and they're going to see it, and you're going to say, what? You're going to say, I want you to call me on my cell phone whenever I leave this interview. Call me on my cell phone. You're going to make your hotline bling with them. You're going to give them all your info. And they're coming back to you. You got to make things simple. Don't make it too sophisticated. Even though there's a level of sophistication you have to appreciate that's part of the learning experience, but then you reduce it down to very simple science. Many of you may be looking at creative positions. Now, I don't have the expertise to tell you what it is to be a great creative. Yeah, I'll talk to Jimmy for that. But what I can tell you, for me, everything creative starts with my meditation and a pen and a piece of paper, or a pencil and a piece of paper. Then I start thinking what screen I'm going to apply it to, or what platform, or how I'm going to build it out. You know, you have to talk to mentors that are in that space. I'm not qualified for that, okay? But what I can say, whatever it is that you do, wherever you feel short, find friends and others in a team to balance you out, right? But today, it's one-on-one. It's you with that person, one of those good folks that are part of the advertising team that came here. They didn't have to come here, by the way. They could have bailed out. Their organizations could have bailed out. You know, they could be here based on, I'm going to keep it 100 with you right now. They could be here because they have 100% commitment, or they could be here because they got a 75% commitment. But they're here. You can turn a 75% committed person to a 100% fan today. And if not today, later. But get the experience and you'll grow. So I kind of went through a number of my tips in the course of the discussion, but I did the research for some of you. I went online because, again, I'm not the most qualified to tell you what's best to do today alone. I could just tell you what's best to be great with what you have. And it starts with believing in yourself, being prepared, and going for it. But I did the research because whether you are in advertising, whether you're in law, whether you're in research and development for any business organization, research is key. You need research. You need data. That's so much what's driving the whole digital platforms that we see now, how data is collected. One thing, though, about data is, in many cases, it can tell you a lot, but it can't tell you what's next and why with the same proficiency that it can tell you what happened. That comes, again, with experiences and relationships. This is why you're so important, because we're representing a multi-trillion dollar economy. You've got to understand that. The black and browns that we see represent cultural communities that represent a multi-trillion dollar economy. And we're all part of the rich tapestry of America, and we're all global citizens. You matter. You're not on the fringes anymore. Embrace it. Feel great about it. That's not going to replace being prepared. So again, just going through these points, and then I'm going to open it up for a few questions, and then I'm going to close. Where's your passion? You got to ask yourself. That some of it just pops right out. To others, it's not quite clear. You're kind of on the fence. You know, where's your passion? And I want to tie something else to that to make you really great. When you can tie your passion to your purpose, when you find your purpose, that's amazing. You may not have your purpose right now, and that's okay. But what are you passionate about? And then what do you excel in? What do you really do really well in? Do they connect? Can you connect them? You know, you may have a passion that you just are not really that great in, and you may need the second passion point. You may want to list your top three or four passion points and try to see what you excel in. Don't give up on your greatest passion, but just understand where it fits in what we call the waterfall of things. Okay, because you want your career to flow. You're at a stage now where it's time to rock and roll. You know, the show, it's showtime. Today is showtime. We're not middle school. It's showtime. So where do you excel, and can you align your passion and your purpose together? Research the employers and know about their companies. Make sure that they don't feel that they're there as an obligatory duty, but they're there because whomever they're talking to took the time to know something about what they do, what their company is about. You all can do that on your cell phone. Just go right on your search engine if you haven't done it. I know most of you have already done this. I mean, really? You're like, really, right? Really? No, really. It's like four or five of you that didn't do it yet. So please make sure you get that done. Find your mentors and your advisors, obviously. Find them. Even if it's on social media. Even if they're not a direct person speaking to you. You can follow many people. You can follow Tracy. You can follow Kevin, you can follow Jimmy, you can follow me at Londell McMillan on Twitter. You can follow me there. You can follow whomever you want, but just find mentors. You really, you know, when one-on-one is better, but make sure that you have those mentors, advisors, and coaches in your life. I would also suggest that you seek to publish and write things. Even if you know, so many websites out here that need content, take your time to write it out. So that you can have something, you can send people links. You can send folks links. That's impressive. Oh, you got a link. On what site? I don't know. As long as it's a dignified site. So when they go on it, it looks presentable. But it at least evidences you've thought about something to put pen to paper, right? It shows that you care. It shows that you've taken another step. It shows that you don't think the world owes you something, but you're going to go out and make something happen. It shows that you're a creator. Right? So write something down. Write more than one thing down. Publish. Try to do as much as you can. And in the course of learning, researching, and publishing and writing, you're going to learn the language, and you're going to learn the art of language. The art of language is going to take you so far in your business and in every business. Each industry, each business has an art to their language. And they can tell in literally 2 minutes whether or not you're a good artist or not. You know, just like when you evaluate a song, you can probably tell in like one bar, maybe 5 seconds, as soon as that beat drop or that melody plays. You know, like Taylor Swift, she's a great artist. You can just hear in her melody, like right off top, you know, this is going to be another great song. Whether you like her or not, you cannot deny Taylor Swift melodies. Even Kanye can't deny Taylor Swift melodies. Drake, he's winning with melodies. Why did I get into melodies? Going back to the language. People can read through you quickly, right? So I want you to understand that. Adjust your language, master your language, master the craft as best you can. We also understand as young people, there's a talent level, skill set, and time to evolve. So, you know, we're not going to judge you as if, you know, you're a 10-year vet. But we want to make sure that you at least know some of the basics. The mindset, we talked about a little bit earlier. Have a tough mindset. It's hard work out here, but enjoy the journey. It's tough out here. You know, I'm from the old school where your parents were really, back in the days, they used to sing you these psalms and stuff. Like, life ain't been no crystal stair, baby. You know, it's all these kind of psalms and stories, but it's tough out here. It's tough. By the way, it's tough for everybody out here. It's not tough for just black and brown. It's tough for everybody right now. And companies have to produce. So their attention span is often short. So if you can show that, yeah, I'm cutting through the clutter. Don't judge me because of anything you see. You listen to me. I can help you with this idea. I've got something that's going to solve that problem. I've got something that the client is going to actually enjoy. I've got a story to tell that's going to match where the client is going to go. You have to hear this. You have to see it. Believe in it. Put together a whole bunch of storyboards. Practice storyboards. Make them up. Make up a scenario. Put in that hard work. Just know you can do it. Be cleverly bold with a good spirit, like Jimmy Smith did with this this idea, be cleverly bold with a good spirit.
It's gonna benefit you.
More specific, we've gotta eat and breathe digital now. We've gotta understand it, but still don't forget the basics offline. People are still human beings at the end of the day. But you've gotta know digital speak. If you're not deeply steeped in digital, my advice, either do it right away or find another career. You know, just find another career.
You gotta be in that space.
Persevere, just be strong, be strong, be strong. Don't worry, you're gonna get knocked down. It's like the rodeo. Be strong, it's gonna happen. If you don't get knocked down, you just have to think that it's coming, some point. And I will tell you, just as representing talent for so many years, those artists that I've represented that didn't have it tough early on getting to where they are at the peak of their career, when they do get knocked down or when they put out their first project and it doesn't hit, like Shonda Rhimes been around for a long time. You know, Jay-Z, long before he got a hit record, he was failure. He couldn't even get on. He had to do it independently. You know, where there were other artists, like I represent a guy named D'Angelo. He got a deal right off the top. Boom, straight to the top. And then when it hits, the recovery is so much more difficult. The bump is coming. It comes for all of us. It comes for every agency here. They've lost clients. They will lose clients. They don't like losing clients. They won't want to lose clients. So all of these things happen, right? So just keep in mind that the bumps are going to come. And so you got to be ready for those bumps, but persevere.
And one of the last things I want to say is an amazing woman in this industry, Sheryl Sandberg. She wrote a book called Lean In. And in that book, she talked about there's no longer a traditional career path.
There's so many different ways to get to the top. I want you all to realize that your career may wind and road, be a winding road, but just get in, lean in, and move forward. And don't forget, you all are amazing. So with that said, I'd like you all to have an opportunity to ask any questions if you have any questions. And if not, I want to give you all a great hand and feel the energy, because you guys are going to do just terrific today. The microphones are here or there, or you can stand up and ask a question. And if no one's in the mood to ask a question, there's going to be a great panel. You all are here from experts who are far more knowledgeable in the specific areas of creative and advertising than I, and you're going to have a wonderful day. Any questions? Jimmy.
I got a question.
Yes, sir.
So what was your bump, and how did you do what you do to, you know, overcome?
I had numerous bumps, Jimmy. You can call me Bumpy Londell. You know, I think my first major bump was the SAT. You know, when you're told you're smart over and over and over and over, and then that SAT comes and you go, boop. Then it was the LSAT. Then I think, for me, on a very, very personal note, I lost my mother at an early age. That was a major bump. Yeah. At 24 years old, right? You do all this work, you say, you make your mom proud, you're doing it. And then boom, some of you may be able to relate to that, maybe, but that was a major bump. You know, when you lose your first big client, I used to always say, I'm never gonna lose a client. When you lose your first big client, it's another major bump. I just recently had one of the biggest bumps of my career. It's kind of like you have to reset, and you can go online and research this. I was the global media head of one of the largest law firms in the world. After I left the firm, file for chapter bankruptcy, largest in United States history, after a number of us had left the firm for various reasons. And all of the creditors come after the partners. So that's a new bump. Bumps are continuous. Just got to get ahead of it. And it's going to come, you know, it's going to come. So I've had so many bumps that I've just grown accustomed to it. But it makes you stronger. Any other questions? Y'all scared? Well, anyway, with that, okay, I see one or two. I see one or two. I see the ladies first. The most important advice that I've gotten is to be prepared and be kind. Simple. And I use it in every area of my life, you know, from what I'm trying to do with both. I don't just own The Source. I own Jones Magazine, which is a multicultural women's fashion and beauty magazine, and The Source. If you look at that cover, for example, that speaks to the type of way I've kind of redirected The Source, where we're very edgy and hardcore, but we still are socially responsible and progressive with what we do. I'm prepared for the arguments that are gonna come my way about how and what hip hop can do and can mean. I'm prepared for all of that. I've lived that life, right? I'm about that life. I'm for really about that life. But at the same time, I know the potential of what this culture means, not just to the total market, but to the world and to our young people. And I'm prepared to make a change. And I need you all to make a change. And by the way, y'all all can reach me too, because we do have internships as well with what we do. But it's very important just to be prepared and to be kind. Just to be kind. Even sometimes it's hard to be kind in certain situations, but you just... That's the best advice I've gotten.
How you doing?
Good, thank you.
When Reginald Lewis told you that getting into business will be the civil rights of your generation, do you believe that now that you are in business and some of your media properties you own?
Absolutely. I believe that now, but I believe it's now become more refined in terms of specifically the types of business. And I think it's using creativity and technology to advance culture. I think using creativity and technology to advance culture. Because when you can do that at the intersection of commerce, you're going to show value. Okay, walk with me on that. Creativity and technology to advance culture, to connect to people. When you connect to people in the intersection of commerce, you will show value. Today's free market economy cannot afford to walk away from value that allows them to excel, because things are moving so fast, things are so competitive. And those leaders who walk away from value, or those leaders that leave value on the table because of their own prejudices or whatever they may have, their own preferences, they may not even know it's prejudices, it could be preferences. But they're not looking to reach out beyond their own comfort zones and find value, those leaders will not last long. And so I'm saying you have to believe in your ability to bring value. And I couldn't believe it more now than ever, but I think that the tools of the trade for the business are much different. At the time, he was talking more like M&A, mergers and acquisitions, corporate finance, and those things are very, very important on a very macro level. But specifically for this audience, I believe your creativity and your ability to make sure that it gets integrated into the technology tools and things that are moving is very, very, very important, because everything starts with a great idea. Everything starts with a great idea, and I combine it that way with, and it's regulated and controlled by the rule of law. Thank you so much, everyone. Have a great day, and don't forget, you are amazing.